Hello everyone. Welcome to the 36th video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I recommend that you do. I select the layer and add the change to color effect to the layer from the effects panel. Using the change to color effect, we can select one color in the image and change it to another color, but other colors will not be affected. Using from, we select the color spectrum that we want to change. I select the blue color using the eyedropper. Using to, we select the desired color to change the pixels. I choose green. In this way, the blue color in the image changes to green. The change menu shows which channels the effect affects. Hue. Hue and lightness. Hue and saturation. Hue, lightness and saturation. We can see that each one has a different effect on the image. The change by menu shows how the color was changed. Setting to color directly changes the affected pixels to the desired color. Transforming to color changes the values of the affected pixels to the desired color. The amount of change for each pixel depends on how close the pixel color is to the from color. Tolerance shows how much the colors can differ from the from color and still match. By opening this option, the hue, lightness and saturation values will appear, which we can change. The softness option shows the amount of use of the effect to correct the edges of the images. Higher values create a smoother transition between areas affected by discoloration and other areas. If I select the hue, lightness and saturation option from the change menu, we can better see the effect of softness. By pressing View Correction Matte button, the image will be black and white. The white color shows the pixels that were affected. I delete this effect and add the channel mixer effect to the layer. The channel mixer effect modifies a color channel using a combination of the current color channels. Use this effect to create creative color adjustments that aren't easily done with other color adjustment tools. For example, in red-green, moving the slider to the left gradually turns the video color green. And the red color increases as the slider moves to the right. Also, in the blue-blue option, moving the slider to the right increases the amount of blue in the areas of the image where there is blue color. And by moving the slider to the left, the blue color gradually decreases. The difference between the blue const option and the previous option is that by moving the slider to the right, the blue color increases in all areas of the image. The colors green-green and red-red work in the same way. Clicking the monochrome button creates an image in the gray range. I delete this effect and add the color balance effect to the layer. The color balance effect changes the amount of red, green, and blue in the shadows, midtones, and highlights of the image. For example, I increase the amount of highlight red balance. In this way, you can see that highlight red increases in the image. I hit the reset button and this time I reduce the shadow blue balance so that you can see the changes made in the image. Pressing the Preserve Luminosity button preserves the average brightness of the image while changing the color. It also maintains the color balance in the image. Well guys, thank you so much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. See you next time.